Hello everyone, Linda Israel here. Did you know that you can make your own glitter cardstock with just a few supplies? So I've got a piece of black cardstock here. It's good to get close to the same color glitter on your paper as your cardstock, so if they can match would be best. This is just a big package of glitter that I picked up at Michael's. And then I have the best glue ever by Scrap Perfect and a paintbrush. So the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to dip my paintbrush into some water and I'm going to rub it onto a towel to get most of the moisture out, but the bristles are still slightly damp. And I do this so that the glue will spread easier onto our paper. I've got a Ranger nonstick craft mat underneath my work surface here, so if I make a mess, I don't have to worry about cleaning up my work surface right away. So basically what I'm going to do is I'm going to take some of this glue and I'm going to make a bunch of zigzag lines across the page like so. Then I'm going to use the paintbrush and spread this glue out rather quickly. But what's nice about the Scrap Perfect glue is that even if it sort of dries, it stays tacky for a long time, so that we're going to have plenty of time to cover this with glitter. If there's any spots that look like they don't have enough paint or glue, just go ahead and add some more. And then I'm going to go ahead and put my paintbrush in water because I want to work quickly on the next step. So I'm just grabbing a piece of scrapbook paper that I can use underneath my big paper so that I don't waste any of my glitter. So now I'm just going to coat this whole thing in glitter. I'm pouring it out on top of it. And then I just have an old gift card or credit card, and what I'm doing is now I'm just making sure that that glitter is all over this page and it keeps from getting glitter all over my hands right away. So now I'm just going to rub this card over the glitter and kind of press it into the paper. I'm going to lift my paper and tap off some of this excess glitter. And there is your glitter paper. And what I did with mine is I waited until I knew for sure that that glue was very dry. And I took it to my Cricut and I used it to cut little spider. So here's the page where I cut it out. And then here are some of the elements. So I got two of them stuck together. So I made these little spiders and little glitter bats just by making my own glitter paper. Sure, you can buy glitter paper, but I was in a dilemma. I didn't have black in my stash. I had paper. I had glitter. I had glue. I knew I could do this. You can too. All right, I hope you like this little tip that I shared with you today. If you did, give me a thumbs up. Share this video with the others so that they can be inspired to make their own glitter paper and be a motivated creator. Share your projects with me by using the hashtag #motivatedcreator. All right, everybody, check that description box for links to my blog as well as my social media connectors, including my groups, and of course the Scrap Perfect link. If you do purchase the glue using my link, I do get a commission and I greatly appreciate it. Have a fabulous day, everybody. Bye.